Hey guys, this is Nefarious411 and welcome to episode 52 of Regrowth. I have decided that I am going to continue some of the automation down here. I've been playing around with different things, and I am really not sure how I'm going to do all of this. Previously, we were able to put a ME interface on top of this hopper and be able to produce these printed silicon. But I was also playing around with the ability to use a thermionic fabricator to produce the the glass tubes. Golden electron tubes, which are needed. The diamantine. I don't know how to pronounce that. But then the Certus quartz electron tube. I am going to break this and redo it, just so that I can show you on camera. So it's pretty simple and straightforward. And it looks like my hoppers grabbed all of my stuff. Ugh, how much sand was actually dropped in there? Oops. Alright, so the way I'm going to do this, first I'm going to have the thermionic fabricator up at the top. And then this will have the recipe for whichever tubes that I want. And in this particular case, since this is the one for the logic press, this is going to be the golden tubes. Right now I'm just going to put sand in here to keep the liquid glass. I have to figure out a good way to get sand in there long term, but I think this will work out pretty well. Right now I'm just going to have a hopper below it. Actually, that's probably not really necessary. So let me go ahead and grab that hopper back. Hoppers are annoying at times because they end up dropping stuff into the equipment. But I might actually just put it right here, because why not? And let's go ahead and put the glass there. I went ahead and created an encoded pattern for one of these printed logic circuits, and this is actually going to create four? Is that right? Yes, because each one of these recipes will create four of the tubes. And let me go ahead and grab the gold. 4, 5, and 2 redstone. And let's go ahead and drop it in here. Let's just make sure that the hopper pulls it out. There we go. And, oh yeah, this requires power. I think that's the reason why I had it up one, is because I needed power to it. I really need to reorganize this entire area. Let's go ahead and break this, pop it down. There we go, this'll work. What's up there? Oh yeah, my lasers. All right, so that created the tubes, and it immediately pulled out into this hopper, and it's just feeding one by one into the inscriber. And the reason I had to have the recipe like this, so even if I wanted one logic circuit, I still have to do four at a time, otherwise the recipe would get kind of weird. So let's go ahead and put the glass cable on this and make sure that he has a channel, and it does. And let's put that in there. And that should be enough to produce four of those printed circuits. So let's go ahead and come up here and printed circuits. I think it's middle click, yep. That'll bring up the crafting recipe. So let's go ahead and do that again, because I didn't see how many. We have 146 right now. So if I request 10, it'll ask for 15 gold, 6 redstone, and it'll craft 12 of these printed circuits. So if we come down here, it should have placed all of the gold and redstone. And Wow. That was fast. And it produced all of these golden electron tubes. And it's just, like I said, pressing one at a time in the inscriber and popping back into the system. And that is going to work out really well. Of course, right now I don't really have any way to keep this loaded with sand. So I'm wondering, if I take a look at tubes, does it say how much sand? I need 500 millibuckets of liquid glass, and I don't know how much each piece of sand takes. Sand. I wonder, if I were to change this recipe to include sand. Let me take the sand out of here. Let me take this pattern back, and let's try to change this a little bit. Clear out that recipe, and if we put this in here, it'll put the existing recipe in there. But let me put a piece of sand and re-encode it, and now you can see that the pattern also includes sand. I'm not sure if it's going to put it into the correct slot, so that is something that we're going to experiment with. So let's go ahead and ask for more of these printed circuits. Of course, this is creating a lot of them. Don't really need that many. But it did put the sand in there, so that is actually good. I will have to see how much sand is actually required for this. So that is actually a good thing. I didn't realize that the sand would go into the correct slot. So let's keep an eye on... Well, let's go ahead and see if I could produce enough to get rid of all of the liquid glass that's in there. So let's go ahead and pop out as much as we can. Alright, so we have zero liquid glass. Alright. Let's see, how much does one sand take? That creates 1,000. Ooh. So there's going to be a backlog because this only requires 500. So what I might end up doing, let's take one of these tubes, and let's say that this, well, not the tube, because of the fact that it's ignoring the tubes and going directly to the circuits in the crafting recipe, I should be able to change this and say that it produces 10, or not 10, but 8 of these circuits. So let's go ahead and change this recipe up. There we go, and 1, 2, add 2 more of those, 3, 4, 5, and that will produce 8 printed. So let's go ahead and take out these and change it to 8. That way the sand is taking care of all of this, so that should suffice. I hope that made sense. Basically, doing the math, and this will make sure that it comes out even, and then I don't have extra liquid glass in here. So let's go ahead and get rid of what we have. There we go. So then the next crafting recipe that I do should come out equal. So if I do printed, let's get rid of that, middle click, and let's just ask for 1. There we go. And this should put it all in here and become empty. Nice. That worked out really well. All right, so now it's just a matter of getting the other recipes in here just the same. And it looks like my diamond kinesis pipes ended up in these hoppers. So let's go ahead and grab those out real quick. There we go. Cool. So what? Let me go ahead and create 2 more thermiotic fabricators. I could probably go ahead and break this one and reuse it, but I have a lot of sand in here. So let me go ahead and do that. Let me set it up the exact same way and create the diamond ones and the Certus Quartz ones. And I think we're in a pretty good position to start working on crafting the actual circuits or the processors. All right, I have created everything that I needed. I haven't actually put the other recipe into this one yet, but that one should do it. But I have a little issue. Well, that went online, but I think the one over here went offline, and that is because I am missing a channel. I knew this was coming up very soon, and it's because I have exceeded the 8 channels that can be used on the normal ME glass cable. So what I want to do is pop this guy off for a little bit. Let me go ahead and grab back that cable, because I can't craft anything without any of my metals. And what I want to do is go ahead and take a look at some of the other cables. If you remember, we created the ME glass cable before, but I want to actually go up to the next step, and that is going to be creating these ME covered cables, and that's going to require a little bit of wool. And unfortunately, I don't have my string farm as part of all of this stuff, so I might end up having to change my farm a little bit to at least craft a little bit of the spider essence, or I don't know, it's either the cotton or the spider essence. Probably the essence of spider makes the most sense. Because if I look at the other recipes, or not the recipes, but the usages of this, we do have the ability to create string, and from the string we can create the wool, and it's in here somewhere, but it is pretty simple. I can go ahead and create string. Let me just do that later, because right now I just want to get a little bit of wool in my system over there. I can figure out the other rest of it later. There we go. That is probably good enough for now. So I should be able to take some of these glass cables and create the covered cables. The other one that I want to do is create smart cables, but that requires these covered plus glowstone and redstone. And there we go. That was kind of weird that it didn't show up. I'm going to have to get more of the wool, so I might end up having to do that sooner than later. But let's go ahead and run down here, and let's go ahead and craft up a recipe. Well, I probably don't need that. I could probably just do some glowstone and some redstone and these 14 cables, and that creates these smart cables. And the nice thing about smart cables is that I have the ability to see how many channels are in use, and you can even see it in Wayla. I have 8 of 8 channels, so that is kind of unfortunate, because if I put any other item on the network, such as this ME interface, it ends up pulling a channel off of somewhere else that I'm using. So we don't want that. There's a upgraded cable from this, and that is going to be some of these dense cables, and these dense cables are pretty cool. So let's go ahead and create a recipe for, well, not a recipe, but let's go ahead and craft up. I thought that was right. Why isn't that crafting? ME covered cable. Oh, just covered cable, not smart cable. Oops, my mistake. All right, so let's go ahead and create. I have 28. Ooh, I am missing glass. Okay, well, let's take a step back and, oh wait, I already have patterns. Cool, so let's say sand is equal to glass, encode that pattern, and let's come over here to the smelter, the smelting factory. There we go, and that'll create the other glass for me. So let's go ahead and grab 20 cables. There we go, and it'll craft the other glass for us. And it's a little slow. Come on. There we go. It's coming in. It's just taking a little bit. Let's go ahead and craft up what we can for now. And let's put that in there. A little bit of glowstone and redstone. And this will create dense cable. So let's go ahead and create a couple of these. That is definitely not a lot. So I probably do need to get my farm going up pretty soon. But the nice thing about these, if I were to replace this cable right here, we can see that this is 8 of 32 channels. So now we increased it from 8 to 32 channels off of a single cable. And that is pretty cool because now we should be able to replace some of these. That is just not going to be enough. 2, 3... Well, shoot. I am going to have to do something weird like that, and that'll do two channels because I have that bus and that bus over there. And let's just do that. I will make a little bit more of the dense cable shortly, but now we have 3 of 8 channels off this direction, and that'll work for us. So let's go ahead and pop that guy back on, and now we should have the ability to create the logic or calculation. I cannot remember. Let's go ahead and do printed, and if I ask for 10, that will go ahead and pop that recipe directly in here, and it used all of the sand and all of the liquid glass, so this was a clean recipe, and it's able to create these calculation circuits, or whatever they called. So that is pretty cool. So now we have this entire thing completely automated to create the printed form. Now we want to do a little bit step up and create the actual processors, and that is going to require these chipsets as well. Unfortunately, I don't have these automated yet, but I could go ahead and put a storage bus here. So let's go ahead and create a storage bus. There we go. Nope. I thought we had enough. Let's go ahead and create a sticky piston. Let's go ahead and get that there. And we should be able to create an ME interface just fine. Maybe not. I did create another 1K crafting CPU, and that's because of the fact that right now I can only craft one thing at a time, but if I put another crafting CPU, this should allow me to craft multiples. That might be okay right there. Let's go ahead and check this out. I am still crafting those 3, and if I do an interface, I should be able to craft this now. Yep, there we go. Cool. So I can craft 2 things at a time now. So just remember that anytime that you don't have enough crafting slots or something's not wanting to craft for you, you can always add more crafting CPUs to your network, and that will take care of it. All right, so let's go ahead and pop that guy right there. 1, 2, 3, and that connects that guy up, and hopefully we still have enough channels. We have 5 of 8 over here, so we are good. Alright, so that storage bus will give us access to any of the things in here, including all of these chipsets, which is going to be very helpful for this next step. Alright, so let's go ahead and come in here, clean out that recipe, and if we look at these, we want one of those, and a golden chipset, and one of those. And that is going to create a processor, one of these guys, a logic processor. So let's go ahead and encode that pattern, and let's go ahead and grab another ME interface because that is going to be needed. I'm going to clear out that recipe for now. Hello? I think it's because it's using the other crafting terminal. Oh no, it's because of the glass. I should probably create more glass. Don't want to use that one. I want that. There we go. All right, so let's come down here. And similar to the setup that I have there with the sorter, I have a similar setup over here. And I put a chest right here, and this is where the parts are going to go. And I have the logistical sorter right there. So let me go ahead and run a cable to this guy and say, you create these logic processors. All right. So now I need the three parts that were actually part of that. So let me go ahead and grab my printed stuff. Just need one of those, and a chip, which is the golden chipset. There we go. Cool. So now I want to probably move this. There's really not a lot of room here. I'm going to move this guy and move you up there, because I think I'm going to have to move. Wow, I am running out of space here. Let's just see how this works, because I need to be able to pull items out of that chest, and then I can put these things right here. Probably can't put one in the middle, because nothing actually goes in the middle. This one, I need to turn that connection off, and let's make this one blue, this one green, and this one aqua. There we go. So we have the different colors, and I might be able to just pull this one straight up. So let's go ahead and take this off and rearrange the wiring here. Let's put the ME interface there. The glass cable right on the back. Let's go ahead and throw that pattern back in there. All right. So now I should be able to bring this up, disconnect you, put you there. Probably need to disconnect you as well. How do I disconnect you? Let me just break the pipe. For now, I am just going to put a cover there, because I think that is the cleanest way for the time being. There we go. And now we should be able to put that there. And that looks correct. All right. So the blue side, let's go ahead and see where the blue goes. Can't put that there. Can put that there. So the printed blue is probably a good place for the printed silicon. So let's go ahead and come in here, create a new filter, item stack, and this is going to be dark blue, and that is going to be the silicon. Bam. Save that. So now, whenever I have silicon in that chest, it'll get routed over. Oops, that went into the default route. Let me go ahead and disconnect that. Let me try that again, because that was not correct. All right. Let's try that one more time. That goes over to the blue route. Nice. All right, cool. So that route worked, and we need the printed logic circuit to the top. And that is not right. So that's going to be the aqua color. So let's go ahead and create a new filter. And this one's going to be dark aqua. That guy, save it. And let's go ahead and create another one for the dark green. And this is going to be the golden chipset. And that should be correct. Cool. So now, if I were to put these three things in there, they should route to their appropriate place. And if we take a look, it is actually doing the pressing pop. Yeah. And it goes right into this item hopper. That is nice. All right. So course, I probably don't want the item hopper here. Let me go ahead and change this to pull out like that. All right, cool. So to test this out, let's go ahead and do processor. We have 45 right now. Let's just ask for one of those guys, and that should put all of the parts up there, and you can see that they went into the inscriber. There we go, and it got pulled out into the system, and now we have 46. I think. There we go. It was a little bit slow, but that worked out really well. Guess I already tried this. Let's go ahead and shift right click that, and it creates a blank pattern. So that was a part of my experimentation. I had already tried that recipe before, but I decided to redo it on camera. But this is going to work out really well. So let me go ahead and create the recipes for the other processors, and we should be pretty golden down here. So let me do that, and I'll be right back. There we go. So I just watched it create the last one, and let me just make sure that this chest is empty now. Cool, and it is. Let me run up here and make sure that this was satisfied, and it was. Cool, so let me go ahead and create another processor. Let me create 10 more of those guys. And if I run down here, you can see that it is busy pushing everything into the system, and all of the item hoppers are containing all of these. So one thing to note, that was kind of interesting, is that there might be a little hiccup with this design. Right now it works just fine because of the fact that I've only ordered one type of these processors, but if I were to order multiples, then there might be an issue in regards to what is actually put in here. There might be a conflict. For example, I might end up with one of these printed calculation circuits with a diamond chipset, and it'll just sit here. Because of the fact that it's just routing to these hoppers, it can't exactly guarantee which combination are going to be put into the inscriber at any given time. So that's something to take into consideration, that you should probably just create one type of processor at a time. Otherwise, you might end up with that little conflict and it'll just snag up the system and backlog stuff. So that might be a little bit unfortunate. So that should do it for all of the processor stuff. I could automate the assembly table a little bit. So let's go ahead and try that out. Let me go ahead and get rid of that stuff. And let's see what it would take to actually automate the assembly table. First thing that I'm going to do is go ahead and create another ME interface. This should be fairly simple. I should probably order up a bunch of glass because of the fact that I don't have any glass. Let me just go ahead and cook up 100, because that takes a little bit to actually produce all of the glass needed for these recipes. So let's go ahead and grab that interface that we just created. And I should still be fine on the number of channels. I'm 6 of 8. This will make 7 of 8. There we go. Bam. That should go online, and it did. All right. So this one will be interesting, because this one really only gives us, how many is that? There's 9 patterns in here. So that should be sufficient enough to create these chipsets. So let's see. If I look at chip, the golden chipset is redstone and gold. So let's go ahead and put that one in there. Redstone and gold will produce one of these guys. There we go. Let's go ahead and pop that guy on. And we're going to end up with the same kind of situation here, because of the fact that you can just throw a bunch of crap into the assembly table. It might not use the appropriate recipe? I am not sure. We'll just have to figure that one out. So let me go ahead and middle click that guy and ask it to craft up one of those. All right, so right now it's just sitting here because I haven't selected one of these recipes. I should be able to go ahead and select the golden chipset, and it'll retain that saved recipe. So let's go ahead and do that one, and let's go ahead and create another pattern. Clear that recipe out. I am not sure why that pattern is in there. So let's go ahead and grab some redstone and some diamonds. This will create a diamond chipset. Let's go ahead and re-encode that guy. There we go. Place him right there. And as you can see, it's already completed creating that chipset, but now we're just sitting here, and it is part of the saved recipes. So if I were to do a diamond chipset, we have 64 in the system right now, so let's go ahead and do that. It puts it in here, but because I cleared it out, it doesn't have that recipe. So if I were to ask for a gold chipset now, we have 119. We're still crafting up glass. So let me try that again now that I cleared that off. There we go. So now it's continuing to create the diamond chipset, but as soon as it completes the diamond, it will fall over to the golden chipset. And that is only because we saved that recipe. To clear it out, we would just hit the right mouse button on the item, and it'll clear out the saved one. So any one that has the little rectangles around it, those are ones that it can craft up. So this is almost done. It looks like the diamond chipset actually takes a long time. So let's go ahead and grab some quartz, and one quartz, and that equals one of those. But I don't have any patterns. Nether quartz dust. All right, well, I'll do that one here in a little bit, because I am going to need to create the recipe. And as you can see, the diamond chipset completed. It got pulled out into here. So now we have the 65 diamond chipsets. And it went ahead and went through to the golden. So that is actually pretty good. So we had 119. And as soon as that is done, we should have 120 in this system. We can see the lasers over here, so we know when it's done, and there it is, 120. Nice. All right, so let's go ahead and create some quartz. Let me go ahead and bring it over to the crusher real quick. Probably need to create a recipe for this as well. But we should be able to create our patterns now. Let me just create one for the time being, because we want to get this quartz chip in our assembly table. There we go. Bam. So if I do quartz, I can request one of those guys, and it puts the recipe in here, and I need to go ahead and activate it, and it goes ahead and creates the quartz chipset. So nice. So now we have a full automated process to create these processors. And right now I have a lot of processors, so I'm not too worried about it. I could create 20 more of those guys, and that should start producing everything that's needed. That is so cool. I like how it paints the items so you can see where they're headed. But that worked out pretty well. Nice. All right, so let me go ahead and clean things up. Let me wait for some of these things to finish crafting. I really need to rearrange this wiring. I'm going to plant some spider essence seeds for my golems to start producing that stuff, and I will be right back. All right, I am back, and it looks like I have reached that wrapping up point. But before I go, because of the fact that I need to get rid of this ugly mess of cables and try to rework some of the wiring down here. I actually need to create one more thing. Let me go ahead and get my earmuffs back on. And that would be with facades. And if we take a look at facades, that's not the right kind of facade. I need ME cable facade. Essentially, you can create any kind of cover for these cables using cable anchors. So what I need to do is create one of these little cutting knives. Use a couple of sticks for that. There we go. And I should be able to use that with some tin, copper, lead, bronze, probably tin. Tin might be the cheapest. So let me go ahead and create a recipe for this. I'm just gonna throw that. This does take damage over time, so that's something to take into consideration. But because of the fact that this was easy to craft, I'm not too worried about recrafting it later. So let's go ahead and throw this in there, and we can create cable anchors. So let's go ahead and grab some of these cable anchors. There we go. And this is a the pattern terminal. I don't want that. Cable anchors. There we go. And I'm probably going to use the smooth limestone. And there we go. Nice. Network aesthetics. And now, if I place it there, you can see that it completely covers up the cable and hides it. So I could essentially route all of these cables rather than underneath the floor. I could run it through the floor, and that would actually be kind of cool. I think I can do the same thing with the Buildcraft pipes. It's not going to use the AE facades. As you can see, that doesn't work, but I should be able to at least take one of these structure pipes, and I think it's with a cover. No? What's the usages for this? That creates a facade. Yeah, it looks like I'm gonna have to use three items. Alright, so that is easy enough. So let me go ahead and craft up. Well, I have some smooth down here, so let me go ahead and grab those up. Ah! Got stuck. So if I take one of these structure pipes, why are you not going back in? There we go. And this stuff, maybe right there? Yeah, there we go. So this creates the Buildcraft facades. And these I can place right on the top of Buildcraft pipes. So not only can I hide all of the pipes for Applied Energistics, but I also can hide all of the Buildcraft pipes as well. So I might actually do that. That is nice. That is very cool, and it's still able to go through and see the item that you that you're connected to. So that is really cool. So I'll go ahead and do that in between episodes. I can also create, unfortunately, because of how Buildcraft works, I can't just put one of these facades on top of this without cutting off the pipe, as you can see. So what I have to do there is actually create a hollow pipe. And if you saw from the other recipe, there are actually two recipes for that. And the other one is just with two items and this guy, and that creates a hollow facade. So this one, I should be able to come over here and place just like that. And it just kind of covers it around, but it still allows it to connect through that little thing, but it makes the lighting kind of weird. I don't know if that's, I don't know what's going on with that. The lighting seems kind of off there. But I am going to be cleaning up a lot of the messes around here with the other pipes, probably run all of these through the floor, because there is really no reason to make it all messy down here. And as soon as I have that and I am ready for the next episode, we will come back and start playing around with different things. I'll have to figure out what those things are, but I hope that you enjoyed it. If you could rate and comment down below, it'd be greatly appreciated. And also, if you like the series, please hit that subscribe button. But for now, this is goodbye.